Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Hope you're doing really well. Today I have a requested video. A few weeks ago, I think it was on the makeup video that I did. Some people were asking for a skincare routine because my skin has cleared up a lot since the last time I guess you guys saw me without makeup. And even since then, like right now, I have no active pimples, which is like literally unheard of for me since I hit puberty. So I think I've kind of found, finally, the right products for me. So I'm super happy about that. Another thing I want to mention is that I am on birth control. I want to tell you which one I am on, but I can't remember right now. So I'll write it on screen. And I did go on that recently, and it took a while, but I think that also might have helped clear up my skin. But I don't know, because I was on birth control when I was a little bit younger, back in, I think I was like 17, 18. And it didn't actually help with my skin, and then eventually I went off it, and now I'm back on it because I'm dating a guy again. So I don't know, but I do know that it does help a lot of people, so that might be something to look into if you're finding that your skin is really bad. Another thing I will say as well is that diet and like lifestyle also plays a huge part in your skincare and the way that your skin looks. When I went vegan, my skin got a lot better, especially when I cut out dairy. Which, even if you guys, obviously you don't have to go vegan, but if you're finding that your skin is really troubling you, a lot of people notice a huge change when they cut out dairy from their lives. There's a lot of research on why dairy can make people break out, and also oil and oily food also makes a lot of people break out. I also notice that whenever I have like junk food kind of night, I know I'm gonna get a breakout in the morning. So those are some things to keep in mind as well. But I also think taking care of your skin, cleansing it properly, also of course helps. So I'm gonna show you guys the many products that I use. I was kind of surprised when I went into the bathroom to like pick all of the things that I wanted to show, just how kind of blew my mind. But yeah, I guess I like them all, so I will tell you all about them. Okay, so I guess I'll start with the morning and then tell you about my nighttime skincare after. So most days, I would say shower in the morning. Sometimes if I'm feeling lazy or showered that night, I won't until later on in the day. But basically every time that I hop in the shower, I exfoliate. Now, right now I'm using the Pink Himalayan Salt Scrub from Eco by Sonia, which you guys would have saw in the recent spa video I did. Okay, I think the siren stopped, finally. So, I hop in the shower and like do everything else that I would normally do, but I also exfoliate my face. I know lots of people say not to exfoliate your face every single day, but I totally do. And I also like to use it with a little exfoliating mitt. So I put like a little bit on a mitt and kind of scrub all over. I don't rub too hard, like I try to be gentle, but I definitely do scrub. Before this, I was using the Ocean Salt scrub from Lush, and I've repurchased that a million times. I love it, but it is kind of expensive, and I got this from Eco for the video, so I was like, okay, I'm gonna use this, and I love this. I also love how much more product you get in this one versus the ones from Lush, which it's like a decent sized tub, but it's like $50 and it lasts like a month, so I'm glad that I have this, and I'll probably continue using this from now on. I don't know, we'll see. But I'm definitely gonna use this up first. So yeah, I should be tapping it. to exfoliate every time I shower. Then, if it's one of those mornings that I mentioned where I'm not showering or I'm not like exfoliating my face, then I also like to make sure I cleanse in the morning because I'm one of those people who gets really sweaty when I sleep, which is gross. And so I like to make sure I wash my face to like get rid of any of that nonsense. So the cleanser that I use is the Liz Earle Cleanse and Polish. This is actually a very old product that I kind of recently rediscovered. If you guys were fans of Zoella or still am, she did a skincare video years ago. Like, I think it was her first one. And so this must have been like 2010 or something, like a long time ago. And she recommended that, and I think that year I was going to England. So I got one and tried it and loved it. And then ever since then, every time my mom goes to England, which is usually at least once a year, I get her to pick up some for me. Because I love it. And I stopped using it whenever I decided that I wanted to only use vegan products. And then I realized one day, just looking on the back, that it totally is. It has the little cruelty-free bunny and it says no animal products inside. And I was like, yes, because this skin cleanser is so nice. So what I do is just rub it all over my dry face, and then I take a cloth and I run it under warm water and then, you know, wipe away. And I just really like this cleanser. It's creamy and soothing, and it's not drying or harsh on my skin, so I am obsessed with it. I really like it. And I'd actually really recommend it if any of you are looking for a cleanser. Because yeah, this isn't like a one-time thing. Like, I've been using this for years. So yeah, that's what I use to cleanse in the morning. Okay, then I like to apply, if I have time, quite a few different, like, tonics, or I don't know, products. There's a company called The Ordinary, which I think you get in store. It's something called The Abnormal Beauty Company, but you can also order it online, and I believe if you spend $40, it's free shipping. So I like to kind of stock up because everything is very cheap, like $5 to $7. It's amazing. Sorry, my voice is like going crazy. So what I will do, and this is my favorite product in the entire world, last week, I think, or some point, I accidentally dropped it, and this is a glass bottle. And it broke, and I was so upset because I use this morning and night twice a day, and I'm absolutely obsessed with it, so I was really sad. And I ordered two new ones right away. But yeah, so this product is The Ordinary, like I said, salicylic acid 2% solution for blemish-prone skin. Now, I'm not sure if I'm saying that right. Here, I'll show you close up. And I'll remind me to kind of link everything below. Why aren't you focusing? I hope you guys can see that. But yeah, I'll link everything. And what I do is just take, it's like a little dropper, like that. So I just take a little bit, pop it on my skin and rub it in. It rubs in like 5 seconds. Your skin like drinks it up right away. And what I believe it does is kind of act as an exfoliant as well. Here, I'll read you what it says here. Yeah, it just says it maintains visible clarity with continued use. And honestly, like, it does. Like, even in that kind of week where I wasn't able to use it when I dropped it, I noticed my skin didn't look as nice. And, like, I really think that of all the products, that's, like, holy grail. Like, I'm obsessed with it. I think it's really, really good. So now I have two. I have one next to my bed and one in the bathroom, so I always can put it on. I really like it, I swear by it. Because, yeah, actually, most days now, I don't wear makeup. I kind of only wear makeup for videos, really. Or, like, if I'm going out in the evening and kind of want to put in effort. But during the day, if I'm just going to school or running errands, like, no. I like to let my skin breathe. I think it feels really nice not wearing makeup. I'm obsessed. But yeah, that product is amazing. If you're gonna get anything out of this video, I would say get that. Get that. It's so good. I promise you're gonna love it. Yeah, so like I said, I use that morning and night. Again, after I cleanse. And then next I have two other similar products that I don't use every single day, but then if I kind of have time and I feel like putting on all my lotions, then I will, but I don't view them as necessary in the same way that I view cleansing, exfoliating, and the salicylic 2% thing. So the first is the, again, from The Ordinary, and this is a caffeine solution, 5% plus EGCG. I don't know what that is. And by the way, on their website, they have, like, all of their products, and then it's a huge, like, description and all the science behind it. So if you are interested and you understand science, you can learn, like, a really good deal about these items. But yeah, this is supposed to reduce the appearance of the eye contour, pigmentation, and of puffiness. So in the morning, oh, it even says you can use it in the evening, but I kind of only think of it in the morning because I'm like trying to be awake because I'm like caffeine, you know? But I just put a little bit under my eyes and rub it in. Again, your skin absorbs it really quickly. And yeah, I personally have not noticed any difference under my eyes that I can tell, but again, I don't use it, I think, often enough to be able to provide a proper review, but I just kind of like doing it. Makes me feel nice, and it is a kind of moisturizing as well, which I have really dry skin, so any kind of moisture, especially around the eyes, is really nice. And then the last product that, again, I don't use every day, but I try to, and this is something I would use morning or night. had to burp. This is the Ordinary Niacinamide 10% plus zinc 1%. So this is a high-strength vitamin and mineral blemish formula. So again, you can see a lot of my products that I use are targeted for blemish-prone skin, but The Ordinary, I really cannot recommend that brand enough. It's really affordable and natural and scientific. It's beautiful. And not sponsored, but like, I love them, so please sponsor me. But yeah, this is blemish-prone, but I was saying they have things for any kind of skin, old skin, other types of skin. But yeah, so this is something you're supposed to apply morning and night before heavier creams, so like before moisturizing, but I'm not very good at using all of these items at once, but I'm trying to get better. And though I personally don't or can't say I've noticed a huge difference from this because I haven't used it enough, they have amazing reviews. I know when I did a haul on my other channel showing this, people commented saying that they loved this product, so it definitely, I'm sure it's great, I'm sure. But yeah, so that's my kind of morning routine. Then I don't really use face masks that often at the moment, but one that I will use every once in a while is the Black Mask. This is an activated charcoal deep cleansing black mask. So if you've kind of seen those Instagram videos where everyone, like, puts the black mask on, then they peel it off and you can see all of the blackheads coming out. That's kind of what this product is. So I like to put it on my nose and this area. And then when I take it off after like 15 minutes, once it's dry, you really can see the blackheads. Yeah, I like this brand so far. I mean, I don't know if I would buy another one yet once this runs out. But it's lasted me a few months already. And the brand is cruelty-free and vegan, which is why I like this one in comparison to any of the other kind of black-colored blackhead masks, if you will. But yeah, I quite like it. Okay, and then in the evening time, if I've worn makeup that day, then first I make sure I take that off. And the best makeup remover slash multi-purpose beauty product is coconut oil. So this is just like a little pot that my roommate always gets the ginormous coconut oil from Costco, and then we kind of depot it into this that we leave in the bathroom because we both love using coconut oil for everything. Moisturizer, hair, moisturizer for everything, shaving cream, it's really good. So yeah, I take a little bit out on my hands and on my dry face, I just rub it in and you'll see right away your makeup like melts off. And then I take a cloth, we keep like a bunch of these clean ones in the bathroom, and River is meowing, I'm sorry. And then once I like wet it under warm water and wipe my makeup off, and usually in one go most of the makeup is gone, and then I will go back in with my cleanser. And if I wasn't wearing makeup, I would just cleanse. Again, the Liz Oral cleanse and polish. Love this stuff, it's so good. So then I will cleanse with this, and depending on how much makeup I had on, I might double cleanse just to really make sure that I got all the makeup off and also cleansed the skin afterwards. Because yeah, you can use this just as a makeup remover, but because I just find the coconut oil is the most effective, gets rid of waterproof, everything, it's beautiful. And really cheap. So yeah, that's what I do. And then I will use this, which is the Ordinary Glycolic Acid 7% Toning Solution. And I use this after that, only in the evenings. Put a little bit on a cotton pad and wipe it all over. And again, this is something that's targeted for more blemish-prone skin. And also just to just say what it does on here. No, but on the website it said like blemish-prone skin and just helping to kind of make your skin clear and vibrant. And I love this. So I use that in the evenings. And then afterwards I might use, well, definitely use the 2% salicylic thing. And I might use the niacinamide if I feel like it. And I will also moisturize. And for moisturizer, if I'm not using the Kiss My Face moisturizer that you guys see all the time, I like this one for the evening. It's the Ordinary Natural Moisturizing Factors with HA Surface Hydration. So this I love because it doesn't just moisturize, but I feel like it feeds my skin and makes it feel more moisturized on the whole, if you will. And like I said, I have dry skin, and in the winter it's extra dry, so I like to use this at nighttime to really, you know, make my skin less dry. And then another thing kind of related to the dry skin situation, if I have a really dry patch, because my skin just is, it's pretty, it's actually a combination because my nose is oily, but everywhere else is really dry, and I often get really dry patches like around my chin. That's like the main part, you know, under my eyes. So what I like to use is, again, from The Ordinary, and this is the 100% plant-derived squalene. Don't know what the hell that is, but this is the most moisturizing oil ever. And I like to put some in kind of wherever I feel like I need moisture. Even sometimes I've put it on like pimples along with all the other things, and it's actually helped to get rid of it, even though it's oily. So this, I really like this, but again, this isn't an everyday product. It's only when I have a very dry patch. I love putting this around my eyes though, for sure. You know, it's kind of like an eye cream, and on my lips, it's very nice. And that cat is in so much trouble. But yeah, those are all of the products that I use on my skin, I believe. Hope that I didn't kind of rush through that at the end. But you know, River is very bad. I need to go and get her. But yeah, I hope that this helped you in any way. Leave me any questions that you have below. I'll try to get back to as many as I can. Or it's better if you kind of tweet me if you can. I have Twitter. And just because there's less of you on there, it's easier for me to see all of your tweets at me, and then I can reply if you really want your question answered, I guess. But yeah, I hope that you guys are doing really well. And also keep in mind that I am wearing makeup, so my skin doesn't actually look this perfect. If you want to see it looking normal and natural, go look at my recent How I Do My Makeup video, fall 2017, I believe it was called. And yeah, love you guys so much, and I will see you soon.